Like all other cooperative learning strategies, even team-pair-solo strategy has some peculiar advantages. In this video, we will take a quick look at some of the advantages of team-pair-solo strategy. In team-pair-solo strategy, students initially work in team and then start working in pair, and later on they work individually. Because of this, it strikes a balance between their group work or group learning as well as individual learning. While working in any group, students share their ideas, views, opinion. At the same time, they also listen to others' opinion and ideas. Because of this, three basic skills are inculcated in students, that is, communication skill, conflict management skill, and empathy. Because students work in group, that's why it motivates students to believe that they can tackle any other problem in group and can find the solution, or they can also start feeling that problems which are beyond their capacity initially, they can achieve this. Now, these are some of the advantages of team-pair-solo strategy. So far in this session, you have studied steps and nature of team-pair-solo strategy. In this strategy, students work on the same or related task first in team, that is in group, then in pair with their partner, and then individually. Thus, they gradually grow from interdependence to independence. There are two approaches of implementing team-pair-solo strategy in the classroom. In the first approach, teacher breaks big task into small subtasks. And in second approach, teacher assign same task throughout the three phases of team-pair-solo strategy. We will take one example to understand both the approaches in detail. First, take a look at first approach, where teacher divides big task into small subtasks. Say for example, teacher wishes to build essay writing skill, or teacher wishes to develop essay writing skills of her students. So while implementing team-pair-solo strategy to develop essay writing skill, teacher may ask her students to develop vocabulary or build vocabulary while working in one group. Then she may divide the students into pairs and ask them to prepare small statements using the vocabulary they have built earlier. And as a final assignment, she may ask them to write essay using all those vocabulary and statements developed earlier individually. So in this approach, teacher has broken the task into three small subtasks. Now let's take a look at the second approach, where teacher assigns same or similar task throughout the three phases. Say for example, teacher wishes that her student should know more about characteristics of CI packages. Then what she should do, or how she can implement team-pair-solo strategy for teaching this particular topic. Initially, teacher may ask students to sit in group, maybe 8 to 10 students per group, and ask them to list down all the characteristics of CI packages. Later on, in pair, students may discuss two or three characteristics of CI package. And in the last phase of team-pair-solo strategy, that is solo part, student might just present the one characteristic of that particular CI package. Thus, now you have seen that same strategy can be implemented in two different ways.